Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm filming my spring essentials, which is one of my favorite videos to film at the start of every season. It's really a chance for me to share with you some of the key pieces that I find myself gravitating towards a lot that complement the trendier pieces in my wardrobe really well. And these are the building blocks that really allow me to create different outfits as well. I'm definitely a believer that the key pieces in any wardrobe are going to be different based on your personal style. But if you're trying to figure out what kind of basics that might work in your wardrobe, I hope this gives you a bit of a start. But over time, I figured out the pieces that I tend to reach for a lot, and these are just kind of some of my favorite picks of those categories, if that makes sense. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if there is anything that catches your eye, I do have everything linked in the description box below. I think most, if not all of these items should be readily available, and if there is something old, I'll try and dupe it in the description box below. So my first essential is the silk cami. The one I'm wearing right now, this is the Cezanne Paloma top, and it is one of their essentials that they kind of keep on doing season after season. So the reason why I really like this one is because of the lace detailing. I just find it very sweet, add something a little bit more like feminine to the top, and I just like how delicate it looks. These are just pretty much the ones I always reach for when I'm looking for a top like this. I also have it in the black color, and with these two, I'm pretty much set in this department. Because these are such a classic, I do like a silk one. I just think it's a bit more comfortable, lightweight. It's a little bit more luxurious for something that you get so much wear out of. If you're thinking about either one of these, the texture of the silk is actually different. The white one is super sheer and it's a bit of a wash silk. This one is obviously a bit more opaque because of the darker color, and it's more of a satin silk. So just keep that in mind if you're thinking about these. I did get my straps shortened myself. I just kind of cut them and re-sewed them because they were so long when I first got them. If you're looking for a silk cami, I do prefer the Cezanne one to maybe like the Everlane, to Uniqlo, or to Grana. Just because I think the little detailing at the front and the little detailing at the back makes this more of an elevated basic and just a little bit more special than something that would be simpler. So I've decided to style the cami top with these blue trousers. These are Everlane's new straight leg trousers, and I love the color of them. I think it is so spring-like, so effortless looking. Okay, so the pants I'm wearing are the lightweight straight leg crop from Everlane. So these come in the prop length as well as the regular length. And I was really drawn to them because of this light blue color, which I think is just like the epitome of like a pair of spring trousers. These pockets at the front are deceptively small. Like I can only fit like two or three fingers in them, if you can see that. I really like this button detailing. The pockets at the back are pretty regular, and the fabric is this lightweight cotton fabric, as the name would suggest. The crop length on me is grazing my ankle. I do prefer to roll them up a little bit just so I have a bit more ankle showing. I do really adore these pants. I think they look very flattering on, very comfortable, and quality wise it is from Everlane. I am pretty much always happy with Everlane trousers. Because they do a lot of their trousers in a crop length, I find they always just fit me well. Alright, wardrobe essential number two for me in the springtime is definitely a blazer. I feel like in the winter it gets way too cold, in the summer it's too hot, but the springtime I feel like is the perfect time to wear blazers. Just kind of mixing them in with more like feminine blouses, I feel like is a really cool look. I have two here to share with you. This one from Sandro, which is a plaid blazer I got on a heavy discount when I was in Spain. And then the other one is this new Everlane blazer in this most beautiful fabric. This Everlane jacket is 100% lyocell. I feel like it's my new favorite blazer because it is so beautiful. But I'm just gonna try both of these on and share with you the looks. So wearing the same inner layer, I just feel like this blazer has a really nice, effortless feel to it. I think my favorite thing about this is how effortless and drapey it looks. Because it's made from that lyocell material that a lot of things I've realized have been in lately, it has that lovely like drape, but there's still a bit of structure with this part, which is a bit more stiff. And it just has a lovely movement to it, which I thoroughly enjoy. Not to mention, this taupey grey colour I think is very flattering, and it really just suits the muted tones of this outfit. I've said this before, but I feel like a checkered blazer is no longer like much of a trend. I actually think it's just become like such a staple in a lot of wardrobes. In Sydney, I see so many girls like around lunchtime walking around in like a checkered blazer, and I still think that it looks so chic and it can just be paired with a lot of things, from like a black pencil skirt at work to like black trousers and even like white denim. I think it looks very good. So this Sandra blazer I have is 72% virgin wool and the rest of it is a polyester. So a pretty good composition, I think, especially because I got it, I think, about 70% off in Madrid. So if you're looking at a Sandra blazer, I would wholeheartedly recommend it when it's on sale. At full price, I feel like it's quite a big investment. I do feel like it is very lovely quality and I was super happy to catch it on a sale. And I've seen so many different variations of this, so if I can find a similar one, I'll link it down below. My next staple would be a pair of white denim. I am of course wearing my Uniqlo wide leg trousers, or denim. I've worn these a ton since I've gotten them at the end of last year and I would wholeheartedly recommend these. I think they are very well priced. In Australia they're like $39. I think in the US they're a bit lower. But these for me are just some of the best denim I've come across. It's quite opaque, so it's definitely not see-through. It's really comfortable and it has a bit of stretch. However, it seems to keep the shape really well. I don't feel like the waist is kind of getting bigger and stretching out too much. I feel like the raw hem is surprisingly flattering. And I also have always liked a wide leg jean. So if you don't, maybe these wouldn't be for you. But if you like a wide leg jean, wide leg pant, I just think these just tick all the boxes while being quite affordable. Instead of moving the camera again, I'm going to show you the cutaways when I wore this last week. I just think like a black silk cami tucked into a pair of white jeans for a bit of contrast just makes for a simple but also kind of chic outfit. I definitely feel like I am a big trench coat person and they make the best spring outerwear. I have the classic Everlane trench coat, which I've had for about 4 years at this point. For me, it's such a classic. It is one of my first Everlane pieces. It is definitely not in like perfect pristine condition, but it is still going so strong and it's one of those pieces that I wear a ton, especially when it looks like there might be bad weather. And then this one just released from Everlane and I honestly just felt obliged to try it. I really wanted to review it as well and be able to compare the two. This is their new drape trench and this is once again made from 100% lyocell material. One big difference immediately is that I feel like this is more effortless. This is for like rainy weather. I just kind of throw it over the top without thinking about it too much. Whereas for me, this is a bit more like an elegant drapey trench. It is something that is not waterproof. It's something that I'll wear more for the aesthetic and if I want something just to look really lovely and elegant on. So this coat is in the extra extra small, which is my like typical Everlane size these days. I have all the information like that linked in the description box where you'll see sizes as well as like my weight and my normal size and things. So honestly, I don't think I can choose between the two trench coats even if I tried. I feel like the classic trench is definitely a bit more versatile. I looked for a trench coat for a very long time before settling on this one because it's very functional and very, very classic with all the detailing. However, I think the drape trench is a worthwhile addition as well. I don't think this is one of those scenarios where you can't have two trench coats because they are actually very, very different in both color, aesthetic, and function. The drape trench is something I'll wear with denim on the weekends as a bit of a light jacket. Otherwise, I might wear it over the top of my work clothes for a really kind of elegant drapey jacket as well. Very, very different, very, very different in style, but nonetheless, I do enjoy them both. A floral dress is pretty much, I feel like, unavoidable for springtime. There are just so many floral pieces out there. But my pick is a floral dress because there's just so many ways you can layer to kind of create different vibes from a single dress. So let's just take this Owen dress because I've worn it a ton lately. Super low B, it comes to a pretty long length and it's just a lightweight cotton viscose material. My favorite thing to do with midi dresses in the spring is to layer. The sweater I'm using to layer today is the Everlane Chunky Cashmere Knit. This is 100%, or this is like 93% cashmere. If I could only have like one knit in my wardrobe like forever, It would probably be this cashmere knit. It is the only like chunkier knit I have in the cashmere. It's so luxurious, so fancy, to be honest. And I would highly, highly recommend the splurge for this one. So I'm actually not sure if Everlane does this knit year round. I know when I got it, it seemed to be part of like a limited edition kind of thing, but it is really beautiful. If it ever does come back or if it's around on the website somewhere, it is a very beautiful, like luxurious piece to have because it keeps me so warm. It's so simple, but it's just so comfortable as well. Layered over the dress, I think it's a very casual look. Casual but kind of chic. It's also feminine, but it doesn't look overly done up, which I like. My next two staples I'm actually wearing. The first one is a striped t-shirt. For me, this is one of those classics that work year round, but for me, I just wear a little bit more in the springtime. This one is from Uniqlo, and I've had it for probably about 5 years, and I've worn it consistently over that time. It's actually still in great condition. It is the thicker material. It's somewhere between like a t-shirt and like a sweatshirt. If you're looking for a slightly fancier version, I know Cezanne does like a schmancy one with like buttons at the top. Otherwise, I would really recommend the Uniqlo one. I think it's just great value. It's really nice quality and I like the boat neck, so it just seems to tick all the boxes. The skirt I want to talk about is from Petit Studios. I'm going to show you in the cutaway what it looks like, but so the skirt has like a beige color and a light gray blue. It's in like a color blocking kind of detail where the back is white and then you got this blue panel. I think this is very flattering. I really like a midi skirt, of course. It's like half my wardrobe. And I think the asymmetric detail is actually very, very flattering. There's something that is kind of unexpected about it, but really cool. I'm a big fan of like anything asymmetric. So this is very my style. This is another piece made from Lyocell. I realized lately that a lot of things have been made from Lyocell. It is a more sustainable fabric, which is great. And in terms of how it wears, Lyocell is one of my favorite fabrications. It always drapes really nicely. Most of my pieces that I talk about the drape of is made from a Lyocell. So drapes really well. It's just also like super lightweight. So in the summertime in Australia, this is one of my favorite fabrics for being super comfortable on the skin. I feel like this look is very versatile, whether you're going to work and you just want something that's like smart casual, or if you're running errands on the weekend, I feel like this look is just versatile enough for whatever. We're getting towards the end. I feel like there's been a lot of favorites. This top I talked about in my spring lookbook, it's from Mango. Really like pretty lace detailing, and it's just like a really romantic looking Victorian style blouse. And little tops like this are always a spring essential. I think this would pair really well with like the blazer. This would go well with like trench, white jeans, the midi skirt. It would just pretty much pair with everything that I've shown you today. I think my preferred is always like a white blouse over a white button-down shirt. So any kind of white blouse, if you're a more feminine style, you might like the lace one. Whereas if you have a more classic style, this Everlane like little V-neck cotton shirt might be more your thing. I really like this top. It's 100% cotton from Mango, and if you are looking for a nice spring piece, I do really think this is very, very lovely. Trousers I've decided to style it with today are kind of like in a matching set with the blazer I showed. As of all the Lyocell pieces from Everlane I've talked about today, I definitely do feel like these have that same drape. I do want them taken up a little bit though. I do feel like it sits a little bit low on my hip right now, and I kind of just want them a bit higher on my waistline. So that's all for my spring essentials. I feel like there definitely was a lot of pieces that I spoke about, and not saying you need all of these pieces in your wardrobe, but these are just kind of things that I personally feel like work really well for a spring wardrobe. I hope you guys enjoyed. I've been filming this for the last like 4 hours, so I feel like my voice is going, but I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'm super excited for some other spring content I have planned. As always, I am going into more like autumn, but I feel like Australian fashion doesn't really have like seasons because the weather does get very temperamental in that like transitional period, and also it's always very mild. Alright, so thank you guys so much for watching this video. Please like this video if you enjoyed it. Please subscribe if you want to see a new video every week, and I will see you guys soon. Bye!